take a step back. Cause it's Ellie's setback. Ah, Mirror Tengu's boxing. Ricky Funes in the house.
Hold up. Let me flip the vanilla right quick when you go in there.
Oh, come on, man. Look, this is the guy that's going to set it up for the Klitschko brothers.
Okay.
What, he wants to fight the Klitschkos?
He's ready to go.
Sampson?
What's up?
Are you ready?
No, Sampson.
Who do you want to call out?
Vitalio Klitschko.
Vitalio?
I'm going to knock him out.
What wrong?
Hook it up and get $3 million. Hook up the fight, you can be a millionaire.
And Ricky, if I'm not mistaken, Sampson said $10,000 a day will protect you?
Yeah, he's a top flight security.
No, I'm
he's
a like bodyguard. Great.
Bodyguard.
I'm the best bodyguard in the world. I started bodyguard like 40 years ago.
He was talking to Mike Epps. He's like top flight security.
I used to bodyguard Michael Jackson off and on. We miss
really?
Michael Jackson. I'm a big time. The Whispers, the Commodores, BB King, Bobby Womack, Atlantic Star.
So how did you end up at the Tengu's boxing?
Because I want to be the heavyweight champion of the world. I've been coming around here off and on for 25 years.
Really?
Everybody knew about 10 skills.
Did you ever spar James Toney?
I said, come on, homie. I was going to whoop his ass. It's not a sparring match. It was kick ass. He didn't want no. Fuck James Toney. Anytime he want to fight nigga on spot, I'll knock him out.
What do you think about Deontay Wilder?
I like Deon. The guy that just, he's going to train?
Deontay, 29-0, 29 knockouts.
With
he's
the
a heavyweight.
Tattoos?
Yeah.
Just came in here?
No, he's talking about Malik Scott.
Talking about Malik Scott.
Malik Scott's another heavyweight.
A heavyweight, the one you say you like a lot, that you wouldn't want to fight him right now.
Yeah, okay.
Let's get this interview, man.
Okay, what do you think about Floyd Mayweather?
Hold up, let me tell you about what I want to get this guy's number right here. I need some cards, man. I want to get this next number, and I'm going to talk to you. We're going to talk, man. Because, man, Mayweather...
He's getting hired as a bodyguard right now.
Don't mention James Toney no more, because he's a buster, homie.
You know, he's going to watch this video, and he's going to have a lot of stuff to say about you.
If he had a belt, nigga, I'd take it, homie, in the ring. He would be no match on a street fight. But really? I'd really hurt him on a street fight, but I want him in the ring. But I don't even want him. He broke, homie. He ain't got no belts.
He don't got no belt. You're going for the Klitschko brothers,
that's right.
Right.
We want Klitschko's, or we want Mayweather, if he want to fight a heavyweight.
What do you think about Mayweather?
I like him.
Mayweather Canelo, what's your prediction?
I think Mayweather's going to get him. I don't think pound for pound nobody can touch Mayweather. He gonna go undefeated, homie.
Hey, what about with you? You think you're?
I can knock him out if he ever fight a heavyweight. But he probably won't fight me because his daddy tell him don't do that. 14-19. Jamel Barnes.
What do you think about Manny Pacquiao? Manny
I like Manny. Huh?
Manny on me.
Monday at one.
Monday at one.
Yeah, we'll hook it up. Right.
You like Manny Pacquiao?
I like Manny.
Why?
First, he was a champion. But I think he should go up and wait and slow everything down. You know what I'm saying? So I don't think he should stay the same way because he got cheated with Bradley, lost, then the other Mexican guy knocked him out.
So Marquez
knocked him out. So he should lead that division and go higher and slow everything down.
But what do you think about the way he got knocked out? Was it a lucky punch?
When who knocked him out?
When Marquez knocked out Pacquiao. I say it's not lucky. There's no lucky punches. But do you think it was a lucky punch?
I don't think it was a lucky punch. I think he just whooped Pacquiao's ass. Pacquiao wasn't prepared for
it. Let's go back to the Klitschko, man. We gotta tell him what we're gonna do. We gotta take them to school. Oh, and his punk ass bro.
I want Klitschko, Talio the punko. We want to fight him, okay? Anytime Talio wanna fight, he can fight the founder of the Crip. Cuz and the founder of the Bloods. Now I roll with both.
I'm the Crip.
You can't roll with both. That's unheard of.
Yes,
you
I'm the founder of both. I raised both all the OGs on the blue and red.
So then I'm wearing red and
blue.
You?
Don't you see red?
I see the red shoes.
Okay, and don't you see blue? This is my blue.
That's,
I wear
okay.
Red and blue. Only motherfucker can do that.
Only one. Cause
you couldn't do that.
Cause you know what the cops used to do?
Tookie couldn't do that.
You know what the cops used to do?
What?
If you were Blood, they would arrest you and release you in a Crips neighborhood. And if you were a Crip, they would arrest you and release you in a Blood neighborhood.
Okay, but see, they can drop me in either or neighborhood and
are
I can fight
okay?
My way out.
But kids today don't fight anymore.
Niggas,
they
huh?
Have kids don't fight. There's no more fist fights.
It's we know that. So that's why we're recruiting them for the gym.
Gotcha.
To try to get them out the gunplay. That's why I don't want to fight the Klitschko.
I'm Crip, right?
To show an example.
Look, Ricky, he used to be a gang member.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Yeah?
Well,
now look at him.
Van Nuys, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, hey.
I'm Crip.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
They're no Crips.
But now
in the
he
valley.
Changed his life.
The Valley had a blood.
He changed
more
his life.
Blood than the
he became a pro
side.
Fighter.
South
he became a pro fighter.
Yeah.
He's a great trainer now. So he changed his life now.
But now I'm trying to get him to fight Klitschko.
Not trying me, but he's up to fight.
I'm just
going to
set up the fight. I'm just going to be on the corner. I will say it.
Okay, who are your top five pound-for-pound fighters in the world today? Who are the top five that you like watching?
Who? It ain't nobody there, but...
Mayweather, Andre Ward,
like
Marquez.
Mayweather. I don't like Marquez. I like Mayweather. I like watching the Klitschko's because I scout them. I want to knock both of them out. So when you wanna, you watch a champion because you want to be a champion. You feel me? So I watch Talio and his brother all the time in my Galaxy 500. Now I seen this big old black nigga knocking out motherfuckers. If they not pad his, I forget his name.
Deontay Wilder, 29-0, 29 knockouts?
That might be him.
Yeah, that's
Husky.
Skinny one, yeah.
No, I'm talking about the big fat motherfucker that be knocking motherfuckers out. He was, the boy showed him the other day.
Kimbo Slice?
Fuck Kimbo Slice. He ain't even in this.
Butterbean?
Butterbean really ain't in this.
Who are you talking about?
Fuck Butterbean and Kimbo Slice.
Why don't you like Kimbo?
Because he whack, Tommy.
You haven't seen him in the fist fights on YouTube where he throws people down?
Well, he's supposed to be a pro fighter now. He's supposed to be 3-0 and 4-0.
Right.
Well, I ain't got time for him. He ain't got no belts. I'm looking for belts, man. I ain't got time for no black
guys. You're going straight to the top. Okay,
Chris Arreola against Seth Mitchell. Who do you like?
Who?
Seth Mitchell, Chris Arreola.
What's the other guy?
Chris Arreola is the heavyweight. He's 20...
That fought Klitschko?
Yeah.
Eating up his jab? That was crying after the fight? Okay. Who do I like?
You're going to make a lot of friends after this interview, huh?
You think I'm scared of that motherfucker, man? Joe Nim offered me $15,000 to go up there to fight that nigga. If he would have been the world champion, I would have fucked him up, homie. Only reason why I didn't go, he's not a champion, homie. I'm looking for champion motherfuckers to
You're
knock
smart.
Out.
You're going for the money.
No, I'm not. Fuck the money. I want the title.
The title?
Yeah, I want to beat the champion's ass to become a champ.
How many fights you have right now?
I fought in South Central, homie, so I ain't no telling. I might be 40-0, but I fought underground and shit with the motorcycle club.
That's
with
tough.
With the gloves and the motherfucking ring. I was undefeated. So I was fighting motherfuckers. I was like 12 fighting motherfuckers 30 years old.
In the history of boxing, who are the
with
top
boxing gloves.
Who are the top three fighters in the history of boxing?
Muhammad Ali, of course.
Why?
Because he opened a big money gap.
Okay, who's
and
number
he's
two?
One of the greatest. Number two?
Mayweather, Floyd Mayweather?
Hell no. Let's go with Sugar Ray Robinson.
Okay, who's number three? Sugar Ray Leonard?
Hell no.
Rocky Marciano?
Of course. I give him props. He's undefeated.
Yeah? Like Joe Calzaghe?
Yeah, I like him too. But let's talk about Talio Klitschko. Fuck you, punk bitch. When you gonna fight a real OG, nigga? Huh? I'm tired of you sissy-ass, bitch-ass motherfucker. What do I gotta come down to Las Vegas and spit on you, you bitch? You a bitch and a punk. And you can't fade this nigga. Whenever you get in the ring with me, Talio Klitschko, that's when you're going to find out what a
okay,
real OG
so if
is
he's
all
watching
about. I'm going to knock your punk ass out.
How do they find you?
You can find me at 818-693-1419.
Don't give him my cell phone number. I don't know nobody calling me.
So there you have it.
That's 818.
What about his brother?
And you,
you want his brother
you
too,
go on
right?
WWE. Yeah, of course. I want the other baby Klitschko. You can go at www.
Who's that?
That's my friend.
Call her over.
He got all the girls around here.
Bring up the ratings of this video.
You can go www. We're going to put it together. www.jamelbarnes.com.
You know, his aunt is Oprah.
No.
Oprah's my niece. I'm Oprah's uncle.
Get out of here.
Yeah, I found that out. And if that's true.
And Mickey Barnes too, right?
And Mickey Barnes is my daddy. The gangster.
Yeah, I know. No, but I'm thinking Manhattan. Oprah is originally from what? Cincinnati, Mississippi? Louisiana?
Yeah.
Which one?
She's from Mississippi. I just recently found that out. And if that's true,
Hey, tell her to send you some money or something.
No, Oprah.
Give her a TV show?
We're going to talk about that behind closed doors. We Barnes. You know, I know you're a Barnes. And if you're really a Barnes, if you're not my niece, I apologize. And then we can talk about something else. But if you are my family member.
You could be the new Stedman.
That's right, if she not. But if she is, then it's off limits. Okay. That means I'm a bodyguard you, Oprah, and you're gonna be in my movie, Reverse the Curse. But Oprah, we're gonna need some funds to shoot Reverse
She can
the
put
curse.
You on her network.
We're gonna put it in South Central, watching Compton. Oprah, I'm gonna crip you up to stop gang violence. You and Gail.
You heard
Gail
what happened to her?
Blood in red, Oprah, you're gonna be in blue.
You heard what happened to Oprah? She went to some store in Europe, and she wanted to buy a purse. And they saw her and they said, we're not going to even show it to you because you can't afford it.
She should have had her her uncle with her.
What? They told her?
Yeah. They said this purse is $25,000. You can't afford it. We're not going to show it to you.
Yeah. Well, they didn't know what was happening. That's the reason why she needed a bodyguard.
It happens to me all the time when I go places.
I'm a real bodyguard.
How long ago was this?
2 weeks ago.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard about it.
Nope.
I heard about it. But that's the reason why, Oprah, you need to lead those.
What would you have done in that situation, in that story?
No, I would have went in there and told them, look, we got Oprah coming in here. Woo, 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 woo. She never would have had that problem.
Shoo,
because, listen, before Oprah go to a store, I would have been there already a day ahead of time let them who's coming and what to expect. So she never would have had that problem.
And they would have called TMZ or they would have called like...
It didn't matter. They could call, call everybody.
That's top flight security,
We don't run from... See, I don't... We don't let, see, it's one thing, if I was with Prince Diana, I would have let them niggas took that picture and never let that nigga drove that car. We don't run from the paparazzi, we just control them.
That's a good idea.
You feel him?
Give them what they want, they back off.
And then they back off on the quick. So we take it slow. You feel what I'm saying?
Yep.
And everybody don't get hurt. But then if you step to my motherfucking client, you get hurt on quick.
On quick.
That's when I roll your ass up. Now, I didn't know a boxing match. It might be some grappling, some kicking, some stomping, or it might be a body slam.
So who you got? You got Mayweather or Canelo?
Mayweather.
You said Mayweather.
Mayweather.
Knockout or decision?
Decision. Mayweather is the best pound for pound. He's never going to lose a fight. He's going to retire undefeated.
That's right.
Unless he fight me, a fucking real heavyweight. I'm the only person that can whoop Mayweather. Yeah, that's because I'm heavyweight.
So I gotta ask you this, are you serious in this whole interview or are you just messing with me?
About what? Fighting the Klitschko? Are we serious?
He's being serious.
Motherfucker, I'm sleeping in a donut shop. You don't think I'm serious, motherfucker? To get the fuck out the donut shop?
Yeah, he ain't joking around, Ellie. He's being real.
I can go sleep with my woman in her house. Nigga, I'm sleeping there to get mean.
But we're gonna have a set date already for your fight, right?
Let's hook it out.
I'm
We serious about that.
We gotta start running.
I'm gonna start running.
No more eating chicken.
I'm gonna start running, motherfucker.
If anybody, look.
If anybody. What's up?
No, I gotta take this really quick.
Oh, no more eating hot dogs, right? You pause there, man. Come on, you gotta let me know.
Get a date, man.
But we're gonna get that date.
What is the date?
Probably December.
You think we can get a fight with the Klitschko's in December?
Hell yeah.
Okay, well then, if we can get a date, if you can get us for show date with the Klitschko's, then I get off my hot dogs. Cause I know what they eat. Cause I'm a personal trainer to the stars.
Of course.
I know how to check it
out. We gotta start running. We're gonna run the hills.
I know how to run.
Okay. But I'm gonna be behind you like Rocky.
Okay.
You know, I'm gonna be riding on the bike, you right next to me. I got, cause you know, that's $3 million, $30 million for you.
I'm with that.
You know what I mean?
I'm with that.
What are you gonna do with $30 million?
Buy my girl a house, Mercedes, buy me a house, give some to charity.
But you say you wanted a Rolls Royce.
Right. Texas.
Hell yeah.
You gotta have that. That's the way I like to roll. That's the way Arnold Schwarzenegger roll. My good friend Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah.
Which we want to invite him to see me fight Oprah, the Jacksons, of course, because Miss Michael, I used to bodybuild all the Jacksons.
You used to bodybuild, right?
Yeah, bodybuild for years.
For how many years? You have any old school pictures of you when you were bodybuilding?
Yeah, I got to find them. I got a picture bigger than Arnold and Louis.
Really?
All natural.
How many, what size inches your arm?
That was 29 and a half, almost a 30-inch bicep.
Man.
85-inch chest. Bitch is 900 pounds.
Can you show us shadow boxing into the camera?
Hell yeah, he know how to box.
All right, we're going to see now the bodyguard, the personal trainer,
and the
maybe Oprah's uncle. We'll follow up. Stay tuned.
And the next heavyweight champion of the world.
That's right. Hey, Vitaly's a paper champ?
You're a plastic champ.
Oh, okay.
Worse than paper.
Okay.
You're a plastic motherfucker.
Look how he shadow boxes. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, I can move that. See that? Oh, you didn't know I could do that, did you?
Man.
Oh, quick.
Hey, but don't show Vitaly too many moves because, you know.
Fly like a butterfly, sting like a bee. Look at the footwork, Ricky.
But I'm 300 heavy. 328 coming down, about 319 now.
There's a guy in Oxnard.
I might go with the mongoose on
top.
Goose. I love that goose. Remember mongoose? You remember? You remember?
Yeah, I remember.
Mongoose. What's
you remember?
Name?
You remember?
Wait, so
what's the name?
Look, Eddie's asking me a question. I don't remember.
What would be your ring nickname?
I got a lot. I got Godfather. I got Sampson. That's my big.
Why they call you Sampson? Sampson?
Arnold named me that because I was the strongest motherfucking ghost champ and the biggest, all natural. 900 pound club, 900 pound bench. That was the world record.
And you grew up with Tukey Williams also, right?
Oh, I grew up with Raymond Washington, another founder of the Crips. I got Barry Raymond. I created a little nigga named Stanley Williams and took him from a 14 to a 24 inch arm. And then he was better known as Big Tukey from the West Side. The best side.
Who's the best rapper in the history of
LA? That was my homie after I buried Big Raymond when Raymond got murdered. Then I recruited Tukey Stanley Williams and got him on Swole. And then introduced him to my good friend Arnold Schwarzenegger. But he flexed on Arnold and cussed on him out. And I said, one day, you might need Arnold Schwarzenegger. Tukey, don't rob nobody. Don't do nothing to nobody. Hey, your bodybuilder. Hey, be in the magazine. Do positive things. He didn't listen. He ended up on death row, over $40, 25 years dead.
What do you say about that?
That's the movie that I'm creating, Reverse the Curse. That's with me and Tukey, teaching you kids, no more gang, no more gang banging.
On swoop,
on swoop, and cuz, and blah, blah, blah.
Who's
and
the, two questions. Who's the best rapper in the history of Los Angeles?
Tupac.
But he wasn't from LA, he was from Oakland.
Don't give a fuck. It's the same thing. Same Oakland thing? Is like South Central.
What's worse?
South Central, of course.
Why?
Why? You got backstabs and lowlifes, motherfuckers that'll shoot you.
And you don't
in
have
the back. The homeboy shoot you in the back, go to your funeral and kick you with your mother and sister and say, oh, some blood shot him or some Crip shot him.
Really? Just like that?
Just like that. That's what LA's
that's
all
wrong.
About. They say keep it real and not real. You feel what I'm saying? So that's what makes LA so dangerous. I got shot up. See all these bullets? I got bullets in me now.
I'm getting shot up. See, that's real Klitschko. That's when I got shot up in 71 by a 38
like
shotgun,
like a butt
45.
Cheek,
that's that Dr. Payne saved my life. I love that buck cheek because my penal cable was hit. I died and come back butt naked.
That's right, right.
Back, God said, bring it back.
On Crick, Crick.
On bring it back, cuz. On Quick, Quick,
there's,
Quick.
There's a guy named Tapia in Oxnard. He weighs about 350. He wants to go down to 147.
I can get him together.
Can you go down to 147?
I'm gonna go to 147 to fight my weather.
Why not?
Because I'm a heavyweight.
But what if you went down?
No, I would never do that. Because I would lose the fight. I would be stupid.
You lose your power.
Yeah, I would lose my power. I'm asking Mayweather, motherfucker, do he wanna fight a heavyweight?
I'll ask him what.
Yes or no, email it.
Can you show me how to hit the bag?
Oh, of course I can hit the bag. Let me hit this one over here.
Don't hit it like Kelly does.
Hey man, look.
Hey, I
just email Mayweather and say, do you want to fight a real OG?
Okay.
A heavyweight.
I'm sure. Hey, Big Church maybe 7'1", his bodyguard.
But it's for money, paid for view, okay? So if Mayweather wanna do it, that's a tune-up before the Klitschko's. And I bet I'll knock your punk ass out, Mayweather. And I'll knock fat ass West out, your bodyguard. And I'll whoop everybody guard your motherfucking ass got, cuz. Cause I'm a real motherfucking bodyguard, blood.
Oh, you know West too?
No rest. Nigga, I'll trace West's ass off the beach every day of his fucking life, man. And gave him his wife, nigga.
Oh.
You know that.
Damn.
So Ricky, when did he come to the gym?
Nigga, I've been in
he's
the
been,
streets.
He's been
nigga.
Coming here for about 25 years.
Really?
Yeah.
I've been here for 3-4 years. First time I've ever seen.
Yeah, he started coming back. He's getting ready for the Klitschko.
See that quick, quick, quick? 328 pounds, motherfucker.
Ooh.
I feel like a welterweight.
Ow, that hurt you.
No, it didn't.
Oh.
See that quick, quick?
How you gonna knock out Klitschko?
Oh, you know how to knock that motherfucker out right here. Hit him in a little nuts. Pow, pow.
Pow. Now, how would you stay away from the jab? Because the Klitschko's, all they do is come in.
You jab. 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 Jab.
Like,
you are left.
But I'm left, but they're like really tall.
Okay.
So they would hit you down.
You see that?
Yeah.
Huh?
You feel that? Klitschko?
That's how you go with Klitschko. You see that body shot, motherfucker?
Yeah, I can still
feel it. But I'm gonna be on you like bam, 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 bam. You see that Klitschko?
Hey! Oh, shit.
You see that?
He's serious.
You see how the Klitschko
ass? Hell yeah.
Come over that string.
Get Ricky in the
I don't play that. You don't play that.
So last thing's happening. Any words to your
Ricky
fans?
Too quick for me.
Any words to your fans if they're watching? People who know you?
Yeah, look, whoever hook it up will get $3 million, right? I want that 10%.
$3 million. Who's going to train you?
No, I'm training myself.
Ricky.
I'm just gonna set up the fight. He don't need no. I'm just gonna work the corner. I'm gonna be quiet.
I'm gonna try. I can try it myself. But I'm. If he hook it up, that's my man. $3 million off the top.